Did you know that empathy in our children has actually been on the decline since 1979? And in fact, research is also saying today that 80% of middle schoolers will report that their parents are teaching them that personal achievement is actually more important than caring for other people. So what's happening here? Why is our culture facing this crisis of compassion, and what can we do to help and turn the tide? So before we get into how do we build compassion in our families, I want to consider a couple of the modern conditions that are what's hindering kindness and compassion. Now, number one is too much screen time, actually. Now, this can really kind of cut down on social skills, emotional intelligence, and empathy in our kids. A second is stress. Stress is another kindness killer. You can probably see this after a stressful day at work, right? How does your attitude toward others change when you're driving home in traffic? And how does your attitude change even toward your family, toward your partner, toward your kids after a really stressful day at the office or wherever you work? And then third, this compassion fatigue, this is a real risk for any caregiver. And in fact, even at the neurological level, oxytocin, which is the love hormone that kind of connects us and bonds us to our kids, it's released in caregiving, makes us feel all kind of warm and fuzzy inside. That hormone actually works on the same receptors as cortisol, the stress hormone, which basically means that it's kind of neurologically impossible to be both stressed out and really loving and kind at the same time. And so I want to teach a simple practice. A simple and informal practice called kind wishes that you can do with your family, with your kids, that's the basis of most compassion and empathy training. You can do this as an entire family, right? When birthdays or other opportunities to make wishes come around, or maybe even just before bed to settle down, settle in. You can do this really anytime you like, but just make sure that you practice these kind wishes in this particular order. Now, the challenge is to begin with acts of compassion that are kind of come more naturally to us before we start to kind of extend and expand that circle of kindness and compassion outward. So I'd like to start by just finding a comfortable position. You can even place a hand on your heart if that feels comfortable. Allow your eyes to close. That's how you like to do these kinds of practices. And just begin by bringing to mind someone who you really respect, who you really look up to, and who really loves you in return. Notice how you feel as you bring this person to mind. And just imagine yourself making a kind wish for them, wishing something nice for this person. It would make them happy. Just make this kind wish and send it their way. Next, bring to mind someone else who you love and care about, a family member, a friend, a beloved colleague. Just bring this person to mind, sending this person a kind wish. We'll move from here to a more neutral person. Perhaps someone you don't know very well. Parent you see occasionally in the pickup line. Person who delivers your mail or makes your coffee in the morning. Just bringing this person to mind and imagine yourself sending them some kind of kind wish. And lastly, we'll bring to mind someone who's been frustrating us lately, someone who's a little bit difficult. As one of my teenage clients puts it, love your haters, man, and send this last person a kind wish, just wishing something nice for them in their life. And you might check in with your mind and body as you conclude this practice and allow your eyes to open. Notice if there's any shift. The point is, we don't have to be actually perfectly loving beings at all times. We don't have the financial, psychological, or genetic resources to literally treat everyone as we treat our own child, let alone even treat our own child how we'd always like to treat and love our own child, right? The point is, we strive to do our best and aim for that middle path of loving, caring, and acts of kindness. Because compassion and even self-compassion, it actually runs in families. And so I encourage you to keep up this good work of practicing compassion, because what you do now really will make a difference for those future generations.